For a month and a half now, a significant intrusion of magma, which I personally estimate to involve around half a cubic kilometer of molten rock, has been ongoing between Ethiopia's Fentale and Dolphin volcanoes. This magma quickly spread northwards along a presumed shallow body of magma at around 2 kilometers depth, which was long and thin, meaning it would have looked something like this ancient dike in New Mexico. Due to more than 100 magnitude 4 plus earthquakes and nearly a dozen magnitude 5 earthquakes, including the nation's largest earthquake since 1989, more than 80,000 people were evacuated from the region. Even some mud volcanoes popped up, and there are reports of large geothermal explosions that formed up to 100-foot-wide craters in the ground. Well, seismic activity peaked between December 30th of 2024 and January 4th of 2025 and has been declining ever since. In fact, if it weren't for the many smaller magnitude earthquakes going largely undetected by regional sensors, earthquake levels are getting pretty close to pre-intrusion levels. For all intents and purposes, it appeared as if the intrusion was on its last legs. This is why it was quite surprising when, on January 15th, a bright white patch of gas appeared inside the 76,000-year-old caldera of the Fentale volcano. This gas plume got more intense, decreased in intensity, and then, during the last 7 days, intensified once again. What made the appearance of this gas all the more confusing was the fact that while the broad 52.6-kilometer-long magma dike, especially its northern section, had been experiencing and is still experiencing ground uplift, the Fentale volcano has been experiencing the opposite, ground subsidence. Since the magma intrusion began, the Fentale volcano has sunk by up to 1 meter or 3.3 feet due to a body of magma underneath the volcano's edifice draining away underground to the north-northeast. The aforementioned gas emissions ran in the face of the apparent declining activity, so why exactly did this happen? Well, during the last week, we finally got our answer. Satellite sources scanning the vicinity of the Fentale volcano's summit detected a significant presence of a gas not traditionally associated with active volcanoes, methane. And this wasn't a minor amount either, as more than 1,000 metric tons of methane, or CH4, were seemingly being emitted from the caldera of the Fentale volcano every day. So, why exactly is this gas typically associated with organic activity in the past or present being emitted from a volcano, and what does its presence imply? Well, while typically not associated with volcanoes, sometimes a byproduct of hot springs around the globe is a minor amount of methane gas due to multiple chemical reactions, including one set done by methanogenic bacteria. My interpretation is that something similar is occurring at the Fentale volcano as an unknown and possibly large geothermal system with said methane-producing bacteria has, after hundreds or many thousands of years, found a pathway to the surface due to the strong subsidence the area has received. This subsidence has been uneven, allowing gas to rise most prominently around its 19th century lava flue, which represents a path of least resistance. I do not interpret that magma is rising here at the Fentale volcano, although more information is needed. One way to test this hot spring theory, which would explain the strong water component seen in satellite imagery, is to check for carbon dioxide and dihydrogen molecules rising alongside the methane gas emissions. While the mud volcanoes, which have become active during both magma dike intrusions during the past 6 months, are still erupting mud, in my opinion, the overall odds of a volcanic eruption occurring in the near future are approaching zero, especially since the dike is no longer expanding horizontally, while there still technically is a hazard. My main concern is not about the ongoing dying intrusion, but rather what might happen next time or the time after that, as it appears that this section of the broader East African Rift is undergoing an intense rifting episode which is likely to last several more years. During these periods, multiple magmatic intrusions occur, often generating multiple volcanic eruptions. This same process happened in Fentale and to its south at three volcanoes sometime between 1810 and 1820, covering a large area in basaltic lava. In other words, it is quite likely, just like on Iceland's Reykjanes Peninsula, which is also undergoing a similar event, that more magmatic intrusions and possibly even eruptions might occur during the next few years. On my 0 to 10 opinion-based volcanic unrest scale, I would currently place the Dauphin Volcano at a 4, the Fentale Volcano at a 5, and the overall magma dike between the two at a 6. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Marmalade for supporting this channel.